Hi, how are you? It's Trav Sr. and welcome back to our adventures in Hardcore Classic WoW. Last episode, we slayed some turtles in Dustwall Marsh, and today we are going to be slaying some murlocs. Probably going to complete a few more quests, too. Try to do as many as we can here. And we should be doing Razor Fen Down soon, guys. Be nice to do it at 43. We only need 3 more bars of XP to get that level. Gonna buy some soothing spices here. Hello. Off of Helenia Olden. I think we need 3, right? There we go.
See you around.
Should be good to turn that quest in. I think we'll do that before we head off and slay those murlocs. I hope you guys are doing well today. I'm doing pretty good. Happy that we finally got a mount. It's making questing more enjoyable as a warrior, that's for sure. And our warlock's currently at 16, getting close to 25, so should be doing some Black Fathom Deeps raids soon. Looking forward to that. Interested to see what Ash and Vale's like in Season of Discovery as well. I'm looking forward to doing Zul'Farak. Probably do a lot of runs of that dungeon. Same with Razor Fen Down. Some nice loot in there, man. We're actually going to start getting plate gear in Razor Fen Down. Going to be quite the armor upgrade. And I'm not too sure where to go next. Maybe like we could go to Swamp of Sorrows because there's a decent amount of quests for us to do there. Or we can, I guess, I wouldn't say skip it, but maybe go there later. It is kind of far away. It's on the, you know, the other side of the world. There he is, Swamp Eye Jarl.
You need something?
Spice? We could all use some spice in our life, you agree?
Ah, that's the spice. Now here's some swampy good stew.
Nice. More food.
Eye juice is good juice for drinking. Too bad most critters only have 2 eyes. But spiders have lots of eyes, lots and lots. And Dark Mist Eye Juice is tasty, smooth, and salty. Unpopped spider eyes, I taste them already. Dark Mist spiders are west of here, in the Dark Mist Cavern. You figure the spiders are named after the cave, or is it the other way around?
Good day to you.
I think the spiders are probably named after the cave.
Juice for drinking. Too bad most critters.
There we go. Got another quest to slay some spiders. Hopefully they drop some white spider meat.
Dark Mist Eye Juice is tasty.
We need a lot of that stuff. And I'm thinking about getting some armor kits on our gear. Probably before we do RFD. These guys give us the Meyer. Nice. That's good. I thought we would have to go down to the water to get these guys slain. But this is a better spot, I think. All right, so let's get ourselves a armor elixir going. There we go. Probably get a food buff going as well. And we'll collect some heads. And then after that, probably go get some eyes. And then we got to make our way down here for the deserter quest. We have quite a bit of quests to do here. Got to watch out, though. We don't want to pull too many of these murlocs. Don't have the best AoE damage, so we're better off just pulling one at a time. I was thinking about the last dungeon we did, dungeon run. We did have a close call. Thank SM Full. Everybody wants to do us to do SM. Yeah, we're gonna probably just stick to doing these quests. Might as well get these done. I don't think we'll go back into SM, guys. Kind of just want to do Razor Fen Downs. But yeah, the last dungeon, it was close. You know, some people might get upset with me that we did a risky pull like that. And the thing is, no one died. And another thing is, no one has died in a group where I'm tanking and Touch is healing. So I'm pretty proud of that. We haven't had any deaths in our runs. So, you know, we care about other people. Right? We're not trying to kill people, you know what I mean? I just thought we could do the pull. And those guys were pretty confident. Right? They seemed like, well, especially that one warrior, the gnome. So, and we got it done. You know, and the thing is, I AoE taunted at the end when things got close. When it was a close call, and it was mostly a double pull. It wasn't really a triple pull. Should we eat here? Eat this fish. So what happened? We pulled the first pull. Pretty much like two mobs out of it. There was like one up. I go in. I think Touch has around like 60. Yeah, it's like 60 to 70% mana. We pull two rooms. And it got a little interesting. I don't think the warriors used health bot. Not too sure. Maybe they did. But I waited until, you know, it was a pretty close call. Then we used AoE taunt and everything just got wrecked. And I don't really think we were grief. Like, I griefed there. That wasn't a grief at all. But I probably won't do pull like that ever again with the melee cleave. If we had a mage cleave there, that pull would just be like a standard pull. But yeah, nobody's died yet in our groups, so it's gonna stay that way. Hopefully I didn't jinx it. I'll be a little bit more, I don't know, cautious. The thing is like, we're going into SM too, like, all the time. And, like, we're just destroying that dungeon. So you get a little cocky with it, a little, you know what I mean? That's what you got to watch out for. And if anybody starts, like, telling me to push the pace or do some dangerous pulls, I just won't listen to them next time. But I'm the kind of tank that likes to push the pace, so if people want to do that, I'm down to try. I wouldn't ever pull like 10 plus mobs, you know what I mean? That's pretty risky, but 6 to 7 is not too bad. Looking forward to when we go arms, though. I think one of the warriors in there was Fury. See the dungeons that we have left here. Oh, damn it. What am I doing? He's going to pull a bunch of shit. Oh my gosh, dude. Dirty Murloc, man. Die to this. I think we'll be okay. We're beefy. This guy's running over to us now. Go back here. We'll bleed up on him. His bleed's falling off soon.
I'm gonna bleed back up.
He ran that way. We'll make sure we hamstring here. So he's only got one head from that. Another bite to eat. This food down here. Yeah, Razor Fen Downs will be interesting. There's a lot of mobs in that dungeon. So we will be pulling quite a bit at a time. But I'll be safe. The last boss is kind of a pain. There's these ghosts that can silence your healers, so you gotta watch out for that. And then there's these skeletal mages that hit pretty hard. And the last boss can knock me off this platform, so you got to tank him, you know, with your back to a wall. We'll be just fine. And then we'll have ZF after that. And then maybe we could do Maradon. Maradon would be all right. It's a risky dungeon, though. But it would be cool to get slay the last boss a few times. Drops a pretty nice ring, I believe. Princess Theridris. This is probably the run we would want to do the most. Blackstone Ring. We'll want that. Try to run that as much as we can. And then that'll probably be the last dungeon we do. The max of the level is 46 to 55. Yeah, maybe we'll be prod for quite a while. Maybe it's just the last five levels we'll run two-hander. Unless we want to wait, we can wait till 60 and do dungeon runs like that. There's no rush, right? The server isn't going anywhere. Hamstring up here. This patrol is kind of annoying. Yeah, we could wait. We could do Maradon later. The gear you get in there is mostly like for pre-bis, just to get ready for, you know, your ZGs and Molten Tor runs. I think ZG would probably be the first raid we try to do. Or maybe just a few bosses in there. That's a long ways away. I'm not too sure if we'll still be a tank by then. Maybe we'll be like a DPS warrior. Got to farm quite a bit of gold, though. You got to like get Petri flasks. You probably want to have like a Titan's flask for every raid you're in. That's expensive, man. So... yeah, maybe we'll just level up another hardcore character and make him like a gold farmer, like a mage or something like that. I think mage would probably be the best for farming gold. And then maybe go engineering on him, or maybe herb alchemy. Herb would be nice because then we could maybe farm black lotuses, but I assume those are camped pretty hard on this server. Maybe buy bots. Also, gold prices are insane. first season of Discovery. Like, one gold is pretty much like 50 cents USD. Unlike Crusader Strike and other servers. It's kind of nuts. Like, WoW gold being worth more than some currencies around the world, man. It's wild. And the reason why I started thinking about that is because of GDKPs are going on and on those servers now. I wonder if Hardcore has GDKPs. Probably not. I don't think so. I've never seen it. It's kind of risky. Yeah, it's crazy how people want to buy, like, level 25 best in slot gear. But hey. Makes sense, right? It's a fast way to get loot. Risky, though. You get caught buying gold, you'll lose your account. But I sometimes I think Blizzard doesn't mind. I think a lot of them like the GDKP. Section of raiding. Which is why they brought the WoW token to Wrath of Lich King in that version of Classic. I wouldn't be surprised if we started seeing the WoW token in Season of Discovery eventually. Makes sense. You know, people are probably going to be buying gold, so Blizzard might as well take advantage of that. One thing they can't do, though, Hardcore buying gold is I don't know. It's lame, but people do it. I don't think I've ever bought gold before, even like on retail. I've bought Game Time with gold though. Don't really do that anymore though, because I just subscribe to the game. And it's interesting because the thing about GDKPs is they allow people that have, like, I guess the time to level up a character and get them geared up to actually afford to play for free, because they're able to, you know, do one GDKP a month, and then after that GDKP they can just, you know, buy a game time. So pretty much in 3 hours they're paying for their WoW sub every month. And it's actually a fun way to make gold. I actually like GDKPs, even though it promotes gold selling and the WoW token. But I it's the best way to make gold by far. Like, I enjoy it 100 times more than just farming mobs out in the open world or picking herbs and stuff like that, or even playing the auction house. It's probably another good way to make gold, just playing the auction house, but need to, like, be interested in that. like looking at data from third-party websites about, you know, supply and demand. Certain items at certain times. There's people that just do that, though. They play WoW, and that's all they do. They just play the auctions. What they enjoy. There's even content creators where all they do is talk about, you know, ways to make gold in WoW. Or what items you should buy up and sell for the next patch. All right, let's get another food buff going here. Just trying to eat all this food. We have quite a bit in our bags. We might as well start eating it up. We're going to be doing quite a bit of cooking soon. So we'll just start using this food buff all the time. Keeping it up. Going to be making quite a bit of the turtle fin soup, I believe, or whatever it's called. The turtle soup. Until we can start making spider sausage. And I've heard the Black Fathom Deeps raid is pretty fun. I'm interested to see what it's like. The cool thing about it doesn't take too long to do. It seems like everybody's just doing it just over an hour. That's how long people take once they get it down. Or even after a few wipes, just takes them just over an hour to complete. As time goes by, you know, people will get better gear and it'll become even faster. Gotta watch out here. Look, you can pull too many murlocs there. Get the patrol. This is also another great zone for farming as a mage, guys. I used to come here on my mage and just group up the murlocs and AoE them down. None of them are casters, so it's great for AoE mage farming. It's risky to do in hardcore, though, man. Because, like, all it takes is one crappy pull or like, a big group of, like, say, like, seven of these murlocs all hit you at the same time and you just die. I've seen that happen quite a bit. I don't know how much AoE farming I would do as a mage, but probably give it a try. It's a great way to farm XP. Okay, let's have another bite to eat here. Two more heads to go, and then we'll have to go turn that in. It's right around here. Stinky's escape, I guess. Maybe we could do that later. Not too sure if we'll be able to do the deserters. It's going to take us quite a while to get all that spider eyes. Damn it. There we go. Get some bleeds up on both of them. Slow him down. Yeah, maybe we'll stop after ZF. Maradon would be cool to do, but I think after ZF, we'll do a little bit of two-hand. It's like solo two-handed leveling, because we got to do a little bit of that at least, right? Leveling as a tank the whole way. We've overdone it quite, I think. Well, actually up to 40 is probably when you should switch, but we'll probably do it up to, like, I guess close to 50. 48, maybe. So I do want to do... I want to do ZF, because we won't even do any Zul'Farak. Maybe we will, actually. Probably max level we'll do at least a couple, like, one run. Because we're going to want to get Gazrilla's... We're going to want to fight Gazrilla and get Caradon's stick trinket. But to do that, we'll need a group for fight the trolls in the hinterlands so we can get the mallet of... I don't know what it's called. It's like a Zulfarak mallet or something. You gotta use it to hit a gong. And then that summons Gazrilla. You can just charge this guy that's pulling on you. Yeah, I think that's what we'll do. Probably won't do Maradon. We'll do Maradon at 60. That's a safe time to do it. And then we can focus on just getting gear. Do like Black Rock Depths, stuff like that. Those will be fun runs. Black Rock Depths is awesome. I think it's like my favorite dungeon in Classic. Pretty much a raid. Huge dungeon. You'll never see Blizzard make a dungeon like that. Ever again. Bleed up on him. Slow him down. Sneak one more hit. You should get it from one of these guys. This guy's beating us up over here. Go. We're done with the Murloc heads. Perfect. Now we can hop on our mount here. Turn that in. I don't think we're really going to be getting any upgrades from turning in, but we'll get a little bit of XP. And that'll get us closer to 43. And then while we're slaying the spiders, I think we'll probably ding 43. And the next... I wonder if we can take that. Oh, we need 30 points. Probably just keep getting improved Sunder armor. We'll max that out after this. Or we actually can max it out now. We actually have a talent, dude. I hate that I forget to upgrade my talent sometimes. It's usually when I'm in a dungeon, you level up and then you just forget. So two more levels, we'll have Shield Slam. Stay on the road here. Shield bash, improve shield bash, or improve shield wall? Probably improve shield wall. Or one-handed weapon specialization. Increases the damage you deal with one-handed melee weapons. Probably that one. We can take that. That'll help a lot. That's what we need. We need damage. It's going to be awesome getting played, though. Maybe we should... we got a coin, though. We should spend it. I was thinking maybe that's when we'll get the armor kits, but we might as well get armor kits now. There's nothing else really for us to do with the gold other than buy elixirs and maybe even enchant our gear. Probably enchant Bone Biter. Probably use that all the way to 60. All right, here we are. Mud Crush, Dirt Feet. Give me food or me eat you. Me like fishy yet. Me know you now. I don't know which one. Yeah, this is Vendors for more. There we go. Said north. This is a lot of people die up here. Gotta watch out. We also gotta watch out for the ogre camp. I think is too. It's right over here. That's where the horde are. Don't want to run into. Yeah, they're there, right there. Don't want to run into any horde guards. Yeah, it's pretty damn close. Where the heck am I? It's a little too close, man. Yeah, there they are, the Brackenwall Enforcers. Don't want to get anywhere close to those guys, so we're going to have to go the scenic route. Guess that's why people die here. The Enforcers come and they just get 2-3 shot. Yeah, we got to go around. It's the only way. Safe here? That's right over there. Stay away. It's like right here. It's where the red is. Stay away from the red. I guess a lot of people are just running into it. And then they die. Hopefully we don't run into it. The spiders give us what we want now. Thing is, like, these spiders that we're gonna fight, they're in a cave, right? Just over here. A deposit here we could get. Still get XP. Oh, damn, there's crocodiles chasing us. And there's where the eyes are. This guy's still chasing us? Guess, no. It's an awesome thing about a mount, you know, you can just run away easily. ...181 mining. I steal these dark mist recluse. I assume these guys stun you with poison, so we don't want to pull too many at a time. I don't think they run away, so. I think we barely take any damage from these guys. It's the awesome thing about playing a Prot Warrior. Barely take any damage. Yeah, it's a good time to quest in Dustwall Marsh. Maybe we'll head into the cave. It's a little dangerous in there, though. You should just focus on slaying the spiders outside. There's a chest in there that you can get. But probably doesn't drop anything that great for us to risk our character's life. I think I went in there on my rogue. Oh, damn it. There we go. Debuff time. Deadly poison, 61 nature damage inflicted every 10 seconds. Thank you. more XP do we need? So close. It's about 2,000. There we go. We're getting white spider meat. This is really good. Make sure we hold on to this stuff. I think we can also get that meat in the Searing Gorge from the flaming spiders. Gotta watch out here, though. Lost our food buff. Okay, so let's get another food buff going. A lot of these spiders over here. If we pulled three at a time, we could probably maybe die to these guys, especially if we have the deadly poison debuff. The recluse has put up the deadly poison debuff, and then these other ones, they're just called the spiders, darkness spiders. They put poison on you. So both of those together, it's quite a bit of damage. Because I think we can kick their debuff. Right, there we go. See. We can now see a cast bar. Turn that on. It's actually an option. You can actually turn it on now, which is cool. I think it's... Is it under action bars? There's an interface. Forget where it is. General? Maybe it was under key binding. It was, forget where it is, but it there's a cast bar option. I'll try to find it later for you guys. It's a good thing to turn on. You used to have to like put in a command to get it turned on. And then they just added it to the options now, which is awesome. Fair where it was, you'd think it'd be an interface. Remember being at the bottom. Oh, here we go. Should be level 53 now, guys. And we can start getting one-handed weapon specialization. We're going to max that out. For sure. Maybe we should take shield wall. Thing is, we rarely ever use it. Prove shield wall. But be good to have. Just in case we ever have to use it. It will last longer. I think there's like a rare in there in that cave that you could fight. We're not gonna go. Caves suck. Especially in hardcore. We're way better off just being out here. Alright, let's get rid of this last piece of fish. Okay, 21 in spider eyes. Watch out going south. We don't want to go too south. So we'll run into those ogres. Decent amount of blue bar. Got enough blue bar. Pretty much to half. Halfway to 44. Let's get some more food here. Let's eat this cheese. And we could use this. Do we have a poison remover? No, we don't. Sold that. Get it off the medicine men and shrink a thorn down. There's another quest we could start doing too. This is more of the Curzon quests. But that cave's pretty dangerous as well. Especially for melee. I don't really like it for melee. I think I talked about it before, but there's a mob that does this ability where if you hit him with melee attacks, you take like do a bunch of damage to yourself. And yeah, if you do like a big ability to him, like you can just take a huge amount of damage, and it just comes up randomly. You gotta watch out for that mob down there. Great for casters though, or any range class, because you just shoot him, he just stands there and dies. Pretty trivial if you're a range class. Alright, so we just need 8 more eyes. And then we'll probably head back. Swamp by Yarl. Oh crap. Okay, we'll be alright, I think. Good thing is they're both. I wonder if they can stack poison on top of me. Two different beat-ups. They have health pots, so that's good. Things get a little close. One-handed weapon specialization. Just putting in work. And I think the next spider will probably get us the amount of eyes we need to finish the quest. I think we could probably avoid going back to a main city. Would be good to just stay on this side of the world. We can just go to Razor Fen Downs soon. Oh. Only one eye. Gotta slay one more. So I want to have at least a little bit of bag space for the dungeon. There we go. All done. We are in combat. Let's get out of here. Just gotta make sure we don't run into the ogres. Try to get to the road. The Blue Fen. There it is, Brackenwall Village. We can actually see it now. It's interesting that you see so many people die around Brackenwall Village. It's mostly Alliance, probably. And then a bunch of people die here at the Theramore Isle port because there's, like, sharks. I think elite sharks down there if you go in the water. I wouldn't recommend swimming near that dock. Does help a lot though. The death log like shows you where dangerous areas are. I don't know why this spot's dangerous. I guess because of this quest over here. I guess people die if they do it a little too early. That's the missing diplomat quest. Where are those eyes?
You got the eyes. You got the eyes. Tasty, tasty spider eyes. Some eyes, when you stare at them, they stare back. Eat those last. They keep you company out in the swamp. Hello, little spider eyes. Hello. You taste like chicken. Gooey, salty chicken. I have cutting to do. I can't tell you what I'm going to cut, but I need myself a blade. A certain blade.
Oh.
Some people call it a moonsteel broadsword. I call it a swing blade. You help me? Maybe you find it in town. Maybe you talk to a blacksmith and he'll make it special. But don't sleep on this. What I'm cutting won't keep forever.
There we go. Maybe we'll get him the blade. Maybe not. It's going to take us a little bit of time to get it, I think. I think you need quite a bit of materials to get it. Would be cool to get it for him, though. And I think we're going to call this episode here, guys. The next episode, we will, I guess, we'll give Stinky's escape a try, and then we'll also finish off the deserters. Might as well pick up Tiara the Deep while we're down there. And then we'll probably be done with Dustwall and Marsh for now. And then we'll make our way down to Razorfen Downs, pick up these dungeon quests. But yeah, guys, that is going to be the end of today's episode. As always, thanks for watching. Keep your heads up. Later.